ones from last year that we got to make 12 of these.
Oh my god, look at that.
We got to make 12. Okay. There you go.
They don't get much nicer than that.
Les is responsible
for
that.
We love you, Les. Doesn't get nicer than that.
Well, it would be nicer if you had them laser cut, but you got me, so the human laser. The human laser. Yeah, that's going to work out perfect. It took a long time to get that really right on the money. And this is all the scoosh, yeah.
And then we've got these pieces that drop in.
You got the little blockeronis, right.
You got those. We're going to move pretty quick this time. I hate to tell you.
Well, you know what? As much plywood as I have, I'm going to make extras of these. So we have...
Well, that's fine.
I'm going to use up all the plywood.
That's fine. All right, we're at a spot. Right. You want to go get breakfast now?
Let's go to breakfast, and then when I come back, unless you want to do them, I don't care. It doesn't matter.
No, either.
These are easy to make. They're just
labor
intensive.
I can be doing that. The next thing we want to do is we want to raise up the trailing edge, I want you to lay out where you want the hinges.
Right.
So you lay them out. We'll raise the trailing edge, and then we'll sand the hinge slots.
Right.
In.
Boy, did that work out? Because the hinges are right on the center line.
Made my life, because I didn't do that.
No, when you don't do that,
I was cutting through an epoxy joint.
It goes over and under, so the hinges go up.
I had to cut them wide and then shim them.
Another neat thing, when we glue it together, put little pieces of Teflon in where the hinges go. Did we do that last time? Okay, I reinvented something.
Just like you guys.
Well, you got no wind, slight rain, drizzle, fog. Can't even see the runway here. The Airport Cafe. Our favorite spot in Hampton for breakfast.
So, what's your name? Your name is Noon.
Rich Oliver noticed that there's women's undergarments hanging in the restaurant here. I haven't been to that many
Haven't got that over here.
They don't have this in Houston? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
No, it's so hot, women go naked. No one wears layers of clothing.
Where's that little syrup? Look at this. Real pure. Yeah, they're as cute as can be. So listen, we were harassing this waitress and calling her Noodle. Let me see the check. So she signs the check. Love Noodle. A good place to have breakfast. Approved by all carbon fiber manufacturers.
We'll be back tomorrow.
Where is she? Where is she? Let's get her on video. I want to see the name tag tomorrow so we can identify you in a crowd. Miss Noodle. Now, all during what we're doing, we're going to be taking high-resolution pictures. Rich is going to be putting a piece in a future control line world. We want to set up the pieces one by one, and we'll try to get together and do an article on it. This is something you want to have a picture of, too, the glass ellipses. Uh-oh. It can't be good if the phone is ringing. We got some of the gear block work left over from last year. And we're going to be making up the parts and assembling, doing the article, putting this together, and shooting DVD. What a team. Oh, you got a blanket. Okay, for shooting pictures. You want to have a dark background, it's good. Setting up for some of the photos that we're going to be needing. This is what a carbon fiber composite wing kit looks like with the two trailing edge parts. This will be the next one we make. Now what Dave is going to do is we're going to pick up the back of, so that the core is up. How much? What do we use? A piece of masking tape or something?
No, we used a piece of
Teflon.
The contest is always on.
But it can be anything.
And then we're going to lay out where the hinge slots go. Put the hinge slots in both sides.
I just want to lay this out before I lift this up. Let's just make sure that we're in the same ballpark.
Well, we can make a little diagram of where, so they're all the same.
Yeah. I want to put marks in the...
Okay, and you're allowing 3 inches for the tips. That's standard.
This is what we had last time.
Yeah, okay.
Right,
if we look at that...
And we want to lay out 5 hinges.
If we look at that, we are looking at a wing that is...
Okay, all the hinge pockets are laid out using a hinge. On center, allowing for the horn. Now what happens is we're going to, again, Dave's going to jack that trailing edge up, and we're going to cut half of a hinge slot in each panel. So when they join together, the hinge pockets will already be in place, and that's how we did it last year, and it really did work well.
Well, you're going to get...
I'm not sure if you can get 3. See if you can do a wiggle job. Can you get 3?
I've got one here.
No, no, one backwards. Well, flip it.
No. Yeah, see, I can go there.
You're not using grain on this for...
I might make it.
Even if you're close, because I can do that real accurate. And even if you had a little glitch in there, not going to be
work.
A problem.
I mean,
you get
you're
3.
Not worried about the grain.
No, there's no...
Yeah, we can get 3. Okay.
The way those gear blocks are in the grain, you almost could make these out of balsa wood. It's that other block that you can't... This is the key to the whole thing, is that wire is long.
All right, I'll let you lay these out. You want
to
probably...
We're ready to do it. Well, I want to get this...
I want to do 3 of these.
I'm going to set it up.
All right.
Right.
Let's lift the wing out. I'm just going to get this out of here.
I'm going to get all the schmutz out off of the mold too, I guess.
You know what that is right there?
What?
That's PVA that didn't dry.
Oh, okay.
Right there.
Oh, that's right. We had a spot right
spot,
there.
And that's the... Yep. That's what that is right there. Right there too. That's what that is. Good.
Do you remember what Les used? Well, because you're going to double it.
He used a piece of 10 mil thick Teflon, which I don't think I've got anymore.
Okay, but it doesn't matter what you're using. We're just using it for a shim. The thickness here.
Yep.
So the hinge pocket will be the thickness of 6 pieces of masking tape.
Expensive masking tape.
Expensive, yeah. Home Depot masking tape.
I tried the off-brand of this, not 3M.
Yep.
Worked.
That feels like it's plenty thick, Dave.
I think that's pretty good. I'd go one more, just to make sure. What do we got? 5? 4 there now?
What did we do last year? We just held this while Les was cutting the hinge pockets?
I think so.
Okay. This really was a good idea. This was one of the real good ones.
This was one of the smart ones we did.
Yeah.
And
it's one that you don't think matters until you go to put the hinges in.
Until you get to what I did. Oh,
man, and it makes you crazy.
I bet I added 10 hours to the project.
No, because the reason was when you glued these, the original ones together, when you put with epoxy, we used so much epoxy, it was unbelievable. When I looked inside the wing, I was putting the tips on, it oozed out like a peanut butter sandwich in there. So with the hinges laid out, what we've been doing, just using an ordinary nail file, cutting the slots in, which is half the thickness of a hinge. And you only got a couple more to go. All the hinge slots will be in this part of the mold. And we found out it's real important not to let the nail file walk down. Keep it even with the tape, which protects the mold. And since it's up, what do we use, 5 layers of tape?
6 layers.
Six.
Half the thickness of your hinge.
6 layers or
and
or.
Whatever hinge you're gonna use, half
right.
The thickness. And oh boy, does this save time and energy later.
Oh yeah. Yeah, you spend 10 minutes now and you save 10 hours down the road. I found that out That first wing we made, the first wing, man, putting the hinges in was a nightmare.
Thank you, Les.
Yep. Well, that's why we pay him the big money. By the way, have you written him his check for this week? Me either.
Hey, this week he's AWOL.
Write him
a check.
Yeah, he's in Texas of all places. Of all god-awful places to go this time of year, where it's nice and warm. All right, let me just make sure we got the right amount of inners, right amount of outers, right amount of parts. You're on parts. Parts patrol. You're going to make the crutch?
I'm going to make the crutch.
All right, I got to make one more sheet of parts. He's cutting away here. The saw works pretty good.
Good job.
Good. Got a fresh blade in there.
Cutting good. I like the fact that it blows the dust away.
Yeah.
That's usually my job.
Okay, this is...
That is the one thing that my son has a hard time watching Windy videos anyway. He says, oh, Dad, not another Windy video. But when he starts whistling,
the whistling
he wants...
It's my revenge on younger people. Whistling.
If my son could reach through the TV...
What kind of toe are you using here?
And stick a...
Is this flat toe or... Yeah. It's got different carrying agent in it.
Yeah, it's the Boeing stuff.
This is the Boeing stuff?
Yeah, it's the same stuff I gave you.
Yeah, but mine isn't flat like this.
Well, that's because you twisted it all up when you took it off.
Mine is all schnurl, but it doesn't matter.
That's because you had rich jacobone.
Oh, no, anything but jacobone.
Trust me, later on this afternoon, we will get you as much of the nice. The nice stuff as you can handle.
How much has he got over there?
He probably has 10 rolls in
it. Oh, I don't need 10 rolls. Jesus.
He sold me a roll. I think I paid $20 for that roll. I said, Brian, thank you so much. I would be honored.
We can make a carbon fiber back for Woody's boat.
Dude, you see the black in there?
Yeah, I see.
There's a little bit of carbon toe in that
All
hole.
All right. Yeah.
It was the perfect...
Thorin is supposed to send me up the prop molds to start making our own prop, so the toe will be very handy.
He's better.
We got to teach him about American...
Send Borat after...
We got to teach him about American production delivery standards, not Ukrainian delivery standards or whatever he's subscribing to now. Anyway, we're laying that up. I love how your wife has those Mickey Mouses all over the house.
Oh,
look at
this.
I even got a Mickey Mouse cup.
Now, you gotta see what I got her for her birth, for our anniversary. My friend owns a jewelry store.
A diamond Mickey Mouse or something?
No, she's already got a diamond Mickey Mouse. But, no, he found, and he gave it to her for her birth, for our anniversary, he found her an original 1956 or 50, I think it's a 57 Mickey Mouse watch in the box.
Oh yeah, with all the,
with the leather, made in the USA leather watch band.
Born in the USA.
He said, here, there's only one person that I could ever think of that deserves
this.
So after I got done spending.
She likes that shirt I had too, that Mickey Mouse shirt.
Yes. After I got done spending $2,000 in there the other day. Oh, by the way, here's this watch you can...
Borat the jeweler takes care of you.
Oh, he's a good guy. He is a good friend.
So the next thing is I'm going to strip out the leading edge parts, which they give us a little place to join. You can see how thin that is as it goes down. Same as a trailing edge. Once I glued them on, and I'll put this back into the mold and dress that all flat. So when these two come together front and back... They meet at a nice parallel 90 degree angle.
Now you've got two choices in regards to how you do that. One is you can bring your ribs all the way up and put the leading edge pieces in between them, because your ribs are going to come right up to the front. You
right.
can drop your leading
right.
edge pieces in between.
Yeah, we just
or
notch them out.
Your leading edge is all the way and notch the front of the rib.
I don't think it matters.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, we could, you know what, it'd be probably better to notch the rib. Because if we're going to dress this off, and we don't know, you haven't really physically finished a wing with this leading edge contour in it, have you?
Yeah.
Yours has got this?
Yours and mine. Yours.
Oh, they're both. Okay, you haven't changed it. Okay, so mine was plenty. Mine was fine.
Yeah.
Okay, so we don't have, we'll just notch the ribs. That'd be, then it gives you a nice thing you can work the sanding block. You don't run into a hollow spot where that rib is.
Yep.
Okay, and we're going to save this piece of multi-layered tape. It's got the thicknesses. We'll save this and just use this every time. We got to do six of these, so this will be the first one. Okay, now that leading edge is sanded in with the T-bar. Perfectly flat here, perfectly flat across. We could vacuum up the dust on that. You want to set the gear blocks in here now, Dave? We got to finish the ribs. Dave is finishing up hollowing out the ribs. We got some more ribs to do.
Yeah, I would use the ones we've got. How many
okay.
Does Richard have done? I'd save the...
Save the original ones. We saved the original set less made. Put some ink markers
now,
on it or
what
something.
What you got to do is you got to lay out the little blocks and
right.
The lines.
Right.
You need to lay these out now.
I know exactly
so
what he has to do.
Lay those out. By the time you get those laid out, I could have some more of these cut.
Okay, let me
and
see
then
that.
Then we're gluing shit in.
Okay, let me see these.
Richard, here's the vacuum.
This is the little things that set the blocks in place. One of the more labor-intensive jobs, putting these little tangs on everything and making match sets. Just remember, each one has to be a set. One set is done. We marked the patterns with a little ink marker so that we would know these are the originals. And Rich is almost done. We're ready to make up the second set. Now, fitting up the gear blocks is always one of the time-consuming, meticulous jobs that has to be done. Each one has to be fit individually to get a nice, tight fit. And we're going to use Rich Oliver's method of mixing Cabasil with epoxy to get even a nicer fit. The bottom one has to be a real precision fit, but the top needs to be just maybe a pen line undersized so we don't create a starving horse here, where the top rib shrinks down and then it pops up through.
Bottom fits the line.
Okay.
The top, I had the line go below.
You took the line off.
I took the center line below the center line of the wing by the thickness of the line. That means the cabasil will fill up the thickness of the line.
Right, and give us like a gasket, act almost like a gasket does.
It'll pot itself to the top skin.
Okay, now we got to basically do the same thing. That part you have is a part. We have the pattern. Got to do the same thing to the other side. So let's make up, and Dave's in the middle of making up the gear blocks, the little covers and things. So we just really want to replicate that again and see that it fits on the other side. Is that how you want to do this?
Yeah.
Since you got a perfect fit and it fits on the other side, I'll just make you an exact mirror image part.
Works for me.
This is something I never like to see during a modeling demo.
Exactly.
Empty beer bottles and a hammer.
Oh yeah.
That's a bad combo when you're trying to do precision work. Superstar Woody Midgley has just joined us for the build-a-thon. Let's see what we're going on here.
I just gotta get oriented.
This one. Okay, Rich has mixed up. What'd you mix up? Cabasil and West Resin or 5 minute?
20 minutes.
Okay. So you made a paste. The paste like peanut butter. Consistency of peanut butter so it doesn't slide. And it fills in all the little gaps. It's called colloidal silica gap filling. What is the stuff we use on the...
What's this stuff?
I used a lot of it on Jacobone's cowl.
Oh, yeah. At the wrong height for... Old guys, huh? Mm. Well, I've got the other ones that lift up and down. I shoulda, coulda, woulda.
Shoulda, woulda, coulda, woulda. Woulda, woulda, bada, woulda.
Okay, why don't you clamp that one?
Okay, and you're gonna just clamp that one. That keeps them 90 degrees. Now, do you try to put a little downward pressure on it when you do that, or?
I push it down a little bit.
Yeah, see, it's oozing that. You want me to wipe that with a...
No, you want
want you to leave it just right there.
Okay. Since that works nice. That is very nice.
Since it's full of really, really light material, you're actually using less weight than if it
and was the strength is you're not holding the engine in a plane with this or anything.
Well,
that's for sure.
But with Cabasil, the strength doesn't change. It's different than like talc. Talc weakens it. This doesn't. It's a filler. So it doesn't change the strength.
And that's 406. The stuff that West Systems sells, colloidal silica.
Yeah. Colloidal silica adhesive.
Yeah. Cabasil is like Xerox. It's a brand name.
Okay.
But
it's Cabasil.
Yeah, you can go down to like any boat repair shop and.
And you can eat it if in doubt. It's in food products too.
They put
show
it
us.
In. They
show
put
us. In. Have a big sip of that.
Woody'll try it.
Woody, get over here.
Give it to Woody. Woody'll eat it.
Woody, you getting hungry for pizza with Cabasil? All right, that's laying in there nice. Oh, my.
Before we go to the next.
Now, you don't see it on a DVD, but we spend an incredible time precision fitting these.
Let's.
Yeah, before we get too cute, let's not forget the gear blocks.
Now, the gear blocks, I'm assuming the gear blocks are going to go to your lines.
Right on the tangs, so you got it.
Well, on the tangs or on your lines? Because your Your lines are different than the tangs.
Go to the tangs. Go to the lines.
Go to the tang lines.
Go to the tang lines.
Go to the line.
Go to the colloidal silica lines. Now see, he made a big problem here for himself. He bought the inner wing on this side and the inner wing on that side. Ooh. And we may have to cut this apart and rejoin it. Woody, I'm telling you, I teach him everything I know. It took 15 minutes.
It was time well wasted. Spin.
Oh.
Here. Give me a nice bead right there on the end of that.
Give him a bead.
Give me a bead of goo on that bed, boy. We'll flip you over, Borat. In Kazakhstan.
Is there really a country, Kazakhstan?
Oh, yes. It's just north of Afghanistan. Yeah. North.
And they're not too happy.
That's probably where Osama is.
Could be.
Hanging out there, actually, probably building foam wings or something.
It's actually worse terrain than Afghanistan. There's almost nothing there.
Oh, God.
And mountains and
there you go. Look at
the valley that those guys are just a low place in the mountains.
This Oliver is okay. I don't care what Barry Robinson says about him. Yeah, what Paul Winter says. He's an okay guy. Pin those blocks in there.
Trust me.
Yeah, that's nice. Went in there beautiful.
Oh, that's so nice.
I can't believe we were in the airport this morning. Woody, having breakfast?
Oh, yeah. I'm wondering if you...
We're looking at the models for half an hour. We noticed there's women's underwear hanging. Oliver.
Yeah.
Oliver noticed there's women's underwear all over the place.
Yeah.
What did it tell you about our brains? Fried. French fried potatoes.
Is this bad boy in?
Get this guy ready to go?
Clamp that one down.
Yeah, when you come to a modeling shop and you see a hammer and an empty beer bottle, you wonder...
A big hammer.
Just how good can these guys be? You ever watch a chopper show? They can't get an axle in. Bigger hammer, Dad.
Give me the mallet.
Give me the brass mallet. Boy, there's no precision to those. They're just hammering things and beating on things.
It's a square peg and a round
hole.
Oh, man.
Front end doesn't fit. Oh, we got the wrong bushing. Hit it. Bang, bang. No problem. Holy moly.
We're in there, bud.
Do the center lines look lined up?
I didn't even look at the center lines. I figured after everything we've done, you had those.
It looks like you got the outer gear and the inner gear reversed.
Hey, Woody.
Here you go.
Woody, they're on your case.
We're kind of busy over here. Could you come over and slap one? Can you?
We'll fill it around the back.
You can roll fillets in there, no problem at all.
We probably want to do that when we put the top on, so that we don't build any ledge that would keep it from setting.
Okay.
Embarrassing moments in stunt history. Gear coming out the top of the wing. For Jack of Bones playing with the back. You know what's sad about Jack of Bone? He wanted to buy an R for an Arc Strega. And they don't make them ass backwards like he flies. They only make them with the lead outs coming
That's
out
right.
the other.
That's right, too.
So I told him what he had to do is order an ABAAC, ass backwards AR.
An AB.
Oh, an ABAAC.
And he probably said that to John Brodak. I want
an ABAAC. Brodak Rice says, what the hell's an AAAC?
There's another guy that bought pipe wax.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
My second picture of the work crew on their knees.
Crew? Boy, that's
for you lately.
That's giving us the benefit of the doubt. Crew would indicate that we might be getting paid for this.
Dad's on his knees a lot.
That's not what your father said.
Well, no, I think you guys were using the radio for your massage, weren't you?
Here we're working the world's tallest stunt flyer and the world's shortest one.
You can do after when it's time to put the top on. Everything's solid and not moving.
All right, so while we have Richard's lower wing panel in the oven, where Dave is putting on the final coat of high temperature wax into the fuselage mold to mold up some carbon fiber fuselage shells.
Look, he likes money.
Money. I like Woody more than money. Wow, look at this pizza parlor guy. What are you going for, the pizza now?
I'm not for sale, Woody.
Woody.
You can't find him.
He thinks if he just puts some money on a table, he doesn't have to wax the mold. Get him over here.
My son, I never saw a friggin' bill until I...
I don't remember.
You don't remember?
I don't remember.
We got all the ribs ready for wing number two and wing number three once these guys stop arguing about who's going to pay for the pizza. What a bunch of cheapos. Unbelievable. Part of hairdressing school.
Huh? Is this a young guy and young girl?
You gotta cool them old. They always give the youngest, best looking guy the hair dryer job. Woody, get over here.
That's a fact.
Get that PVA drying. We got fuselages to make. Beautiful piece of work. Got the wing cutout already in it.
We never painted trim on it, but we always painted white. So it would come out, basically touch up the seam line.
But the guys that are doing that, they paint the trim in there and everything, according to that video.
It comes out of the mold.
Oh, yeah.
It's got the USAF, the star, and maybe they use decal. I never thought of that.
They can use
like
some,
reverse decals?
They are so intricate. It is alluring.
Can you feel it? Oh, yeah. A little goopy, it's totally goopy. Yeah, leave that in there. Put the heat back on it. Are you kidding me?
No, the heat will make it softer.
It'll make it cure quicker.
Just let it cool and it makes it faster. You want to hit it with the heat gun?
Yeah, it's not. Unless you just want this up out of the way, I'd just leave it on it while we're eating.
Leave it on while we're eating.
We'll put the pizza right on top of it.
Hold on.
Who dripped all this epoxy on the floor? Did you do that working?
Not me.
He said you did it.
He wouldn't let me near the epoxy stick.
He said you did it. What, are you going to leave a heat lamp on it while we're eating?
Why not?
Burn a hole in the wing.
Yeah.
All right, while we're eating, you just stand here and hold it. Oh, man, look at this action. Look at this. We're at Pina Munda here, trying to get it. Or is it Pina Mundro? Look at this guy. Oh boy. I'll tell you. What a guy.
Shut up.
Yeah, just shutting that fan off will raise the temperature 80 degrees in here. Put one of those pretzels on it, those clothespins.
That's it.
Just need a little resistance.
We come back from eating, there'll be a hole in a wing, no problem. Be easier to put the bell crank in.
What's wrong with that?
This is what makes these molds work best. After midnight, Corona Extra. That's what makes these molds cook good. Let's see what that looks like. This is old New Joe's New York pizza. Oh, this must be good. Oh yeah, that's good.
Pepperoni.
That's good. That's good. I'll take it.
Pizza place. There you go.
Joe's New York pizza in to a Texan in New Hampshire. It's what makes these wings cook.
Did Joe move to New Hampshire? Is that
yeah, probably. Now, there's a story here. Notice, she has some drink. The pizza's already in the house. Not that she's a wild woman, but check this. That is nice.
Is that awesome or what?
Wow. What's the story? Shoplifting?
The story is a girl that was one of my Girl Scouts.
Right.
Dad was cleaning out his attic.
And he found it.
He saw that and said, hey, I bet Mrs. Midgley would like that.
I bet.
I don't know what made him think that.
I don't know where he got that idea. It's unbelievable where he got that idea.
Your anniversary present.
I will. I mean, not to be mean, Dave, but
yeah.
I'm a saddle horse.
The pizza's getting me. Pizza's getting cold. Woody just put the pie upstairs.
I don't think.
Now is when we usually separate the men from the boys. We're headed toward midnight. We want to get the second one bagged. So one of them's here. The gear block. This is Richard's, I think. Gear blocks are in. This gives you an idea how many mixes of Cabasil and epoxy we made tonight. Still gooey. Nice. Woody's on material cleanup. Dave's getting another shell set for the gear blocks. Repeat the same thing we did on yours, Rich, because I'll get a fresh pizza box. We'll do the same mixes and everything.
Yeah.
Okay, that worked out well.
Let's see if everything fits first.
Yeah, well, you want to do the fits first. Even though we use the Riches for patterns. Those are the inners. Yellow or inner, pink or outer. Just make sure the sprues are going toward each other.
Richard can check and see if my center line.
You got your center lines in there?
That looks good.
Right on center.
Good.
That Les is amazing, I'll tell you.
You like him?
I'll tell you, that Les, we got to send him a package.
That's awesome.
Send him a pizza. All right, this one's going to sit here 10, 15 minutes. We bag up another one.
Yep. This is really nice.
This one went in nice.
Yeah, this one is real nice.
You got nice little glue fillets around the edges?
Yes, Richard.
That's what I'm saying. If yours goes in not nearly as nice, we know something's afoot here.
The mold moved. The mold moved. No, when we're going to know is when we're in Texas and the sun is shining on the top of those ribs. Whose ribs don't show through and whose do?
And whose airplane gets tripped over?
Get the gram scale. Well, yours is probably, you got thicker wood, right? A couple thousandths thicker?
Mine, which it worked out to be 25, and yours was between 20 and 25.
Oh, well, get the scale. What the hell's scale?
Well, you're
mixing
wood.
Okay, getting ready to lay up the third one here. Once we get that in the bag and in the box, we actually could get some sleep tonight. Two down. Both layers of cloth on there?
Nope. Both layers of cloth, yep.
Now, when you did it in this in pylon, you always put.
Cut our fenders tonight.
We didn't cut those last. Yes, you did.
Did we cut these last night?
I don't think we did.
Did we get one set or both sets?
I thought you did both sets last night. I think we did.
Let's check them. Easier to check them now.
Good cut. Yeah, we have marked them. Somewhere I've got a black.
Okay, those skins are. When you did pylon races, you always put the half ounce cloth right on a skin, just like what we're doing here.
Yep.
And then back it up with 3/4.
It depended. Sometimes you would 3/4 and then 1 ounce or 1.5 ounces.
Okay.
But
the half always on the skin.
That was the side you wanted to show the slickest finish.
Right.
Because
the one thing I'm impressed with is the finish on these.
Yeah. If
you were looking like, if you really wanted to just have the light finish, you could scuff that, probably put one coat of white or...
White primer.
Yeah.
Well, sports fans, this football can only handle 3 monkeys. So the 4th one stepped behind the camera.
It's a 3 monkey circus. Nice to be in management, isn't it, Rich?
Yes. No, by the way, get back to work. We don't have time to talk.
Please, Mr. Custer.
How do you think I'm paying you for?
Two layers outside, wing skins, 1 layer inside.
I don't want to go.
We're hoping by the next 4 to 5 wings that Wendy will have learned how to do this.
One more ellipse going in here.
I need a concourse prep. I need it so badly.
Yeah, last session he held a heat dryer, a hair dryer.
I was demoted. I'm in labor now. And they asked to see my green card. Can you imagine?
I don't have a green card.
Why, Elliot's on his way.
Elliot's on his way, yeah. We're calling for the British. It's like a world in reverse. They rescue
ellipses.
Us. All right.
There's 2 on the outside, 2 on the inside.
There you go. I taught him well, Woody.
I know you did.
I taught him well.
I know.
Took me 30 seconds.
If only we could teach Elliot
something. Oh, no.
He taught me everything I know about exterior illumination, Dad.
Aliens are coming for you, Dave.
Yeah.
But don't worry. They're only taking the good-looking people. So you're safe.
Give me some heat here, Woody.
Come on.
Gotcha.
The hell are we paying you
gotcha.
For?
No, I was waiting to make damn
sure.
What,
a pension plan?
I know, I didn't want to get under it.
Oh, man.
Time to get a new monkey.
Right. Call a zoo, let's get another gorilla. Give this guy a banana. Yeah.
The bride cuts the bleeder cloth. The bride cuts the bleeder cloth.
She's gonna bleed all right.
Oh, look at this, look at this. Using his razor sharp scissors and a keen eye for a straight cut. Oh man, if Elliot was here, we'd have so much fun.
Oh Jesus.
It just isn't the same. It's like a build-a-thon without Elliot is like a day without sunshine.
Yeah, it makes it. Okay. I thought maybe...
Cut off a couple inches, don't you? An inch at least.
Oh, yeah. But one of these pieces was short, and we had to add a little piece to it, and I guess it was that.
This stuff I don't like.
This is the new stuff I got. I really don't like it.
That's just the
it's too
the new stuff?
I want tighter weave and half the thickness.
You on there, Woody?
I think so. Pretty stiff piece of. Yep. Now the trailing edge wants to go straight back. Just want to push that in and. seven or eight pulls on this one bag without a hole.
Yeah.
We used to make a new bag for every...
I'm surprised at some of these corners up here, too, you know?
Yeah, you got some...
Well, I should have rounded them off with a file, but I never got to it. Here she comes. She's looking.
Getting ready to suck down?
Yeah. She's lifting. Hold on here.
Get that up on top.
I got it up here. It's way up here. There she goes.
Oh, there we go. There you go.
It changes tone when it changes pitch.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Yeah.
There she goes.
There it goes. Yep. Atmospheric pressure at work.
Yep. It's not there yet. It's getting there now.
It's coming.
This stuff takes a while for even this to suck down.
Is this always up a little bit like this?
Yep. Yeah, because the wood rolls up and goes over the edge.
Okay, remember? I know where it is. Okay.
Yeah. We're good. Let's put the lights on it and go to bed.
That's on as far as it'll go, but it isn't much.
That's just going to sit there overnight. Rich Oliver's going to stay up overnight and babysit it while we all get a good night's sleep. Oh, I'm glad that's done. There's a report aliens have landed in Hampton, New Hampshire. That's got to sit there overnight. When you weighed them, what were they? Within 3 grams of each other?
Within 3 grams.
Within 3. Poco Rabundo.
I've been up since the crack of dawn. They look absolutely, they fit like a...
Sure they do. Fit nice?
Oh yeah. My
okay.
God.
Yeah, of course they do. There's no hump at all, so none of the ribs. See it?
Beautiful.
Yeah. Nothing needs to be sanded.
You don't even need to mold the gloom, just put duct tape around the end and let's go flying.
No, the only thing that's,
here's one of the most exciting things when Lyle first started doing all composite airplanes.
Yeah, yeah.
Look at that.
200 miles an hour.
That's a new type of brake.
I got to tell him that when I see him at the Nats.
Air brake.
Oh, Lyle's custom air brake service.
I need to watch one and one clamshell open. So after a while, he nosed down. Get it up to about 200 and just
I like when Jimmy Snyder was flying around and the monocoque came off the wing of his plane. Oh, he was flying ribs. It turned into a car instantly.
What the hell do you want, old woman?
Must be talking to his wife.
One, put the nose down, you're up at 200 miles an hour. I back to go around number 3, and the airplane goes, sits down right there.
Jesus.
My God, what happened? On his wheels. Didn't break anything, didn't pop,
no
didn't
kidding.
Break the proper distance. Within 25 feet, it stops, goes into this bad spin, and sits right there. The stabs are composite. They're two-piece, they slide up onto a rod. And they're taped just to keep them from pulling out. One of them did this.
Oh, yeah.
But I've never seen an airplane stop instantly from 200 miles an hour, go into a flat spin and set on the ground.
That's what I like best about New England. Everybody's got their wood pile.
It never looks like this in Texas.
No, it never does. All right, we're off to breakfast. Friday morning at the Build-A-Thon. What do you want to do, just put that in the garage?
Yeah, we'll just put it right here.
Will a 90 fit in that?
Bet your ass. Yes, it will.
I know a guy's got a 90 and a grind. I know a guy's got a big Dremel tool. We get that in this afternoon.
Yes, I do.
All right, carbon boy, let's eat. Time to eat. New England is so beautiful this time of year.
Oh.
Look at this. Not a leaf on a tree, a gray sky.
Yeah, but it's 65 degrees out. No.
Yeah. Let me tell you, we should be flying. This is nice. We should go flying now before it rains some more.
No, it's
rain
supposed
for two
to, no,
days.
It's supposed to clear up more this afternoon.
More?
Full liter 30-30 mixes.
There's a place that has woolly old cars inside.
Yeah.
They're not out today.
Got any mate. Welch, W-E-L-C-H. Usually it's personally for me. And I usually just walk in on. That would be great.
How's that for a barbecue? Look at this thing. Very cool. Cool little airport. We always love coming out here. Are we gonna have some fun with Noodle if she's here today? She's here. I want to audition for a job here. Who do I have to see to get a job?
That's funny.
40 seats us underneath the woman's underwear. I don't get it, Woody. How do you? He's just a lucky man, I guess.
We were here when
she won't let us take her picture. How embarrassing. She'll never be a playmate on my calendar. Is it? Yeah, wind's coming up. All right, let's go work on wings. You're going to the glue factory?
I'll go to the...
the horse glue factory? Richard and I will go work on wings. Give you a wild guess whose car this might be. Let's go to work. Now, the way we're going to do this, the first step on putting these gear blocks in, we have to make the hatches and covers. We took some 440 bolts, put a point on them. We're going to run that down through the hatch. We need an Allen wrench too, Rich. Even a ball driver. We need to run that through. It's going to come out the other end. It's going to go right through the wing skin and identify where this hatch is going to go. You can see it's poking its way through, and that's going to give us a rough idea where that hatch is going to ultimately wind up. Okay, you can see where these have come up through. Now, because each one is marked, this one is number 2. This is the one that's marked Rich Oliver, number 2. Okay, now we'll take a nice pen that usually doesn't write, so you have to do it with tape. Give me some tape, Rich. I'd rather do it with tape. The pens really don't write on this. It's still got PVA on it. Just give me some tape. We're going to make the outline. We're going to undersize it. And then just very carefully fit this in. That's good. We'll just make a little box with tape. So this just helps us locate where that hole has to be. That basically tells us where we need to cut. And I'm going to cut this undersize now. Where's the blade? We got a decent blade here? Kevin forbid we should buy new blades.
Looks pretty good.
Yeah, this is the Midgley's version scalpel blade. I'm going to cut it plenty undersize. Because the choices you have is you can undersize the block, that's no problem. Or you can just simply keep grinding a hole bigger until you get the fit that you want. Might want to look for a new blade. We were using this one to cut all that stuff last night. He's got a whole box of them up there too. Then we want to get a little sanding, like a nail file, you know, so we can get the edges crisp. Sanding block, sanding something. I like to make one out of a little piece of motor mount that has 90 degree edges if he has one. Real easy. I also, if you got any oil over there, put a drop of oil on these blind nuts, just in case we drip some hot stuff down there, we're not going to make ourselves a problem.
That's as close as I can come to motor now.
Okay, can you make like a little sanding? You know what I want to do. Make it the width, less than the width of this, so we can just go back and forth. That'll work. I'm going to cut this carefully. And then we'll do the final fit with a sanding block. Well, Rich made up some sanding blocks. We're going to get in here. He's making one for this dimension. So we can get in here and get these edges all nice and true. All right, we got the first one just drop fit in. We got to put the bolts in. Ready to start working on the edges, get the nice tight fit there. The next step is with a sharpened piece of tubing just to get the holes relieved that we can drop the bolt heads down into the block. And then we'll put that right back in place. Okay, now we've got these holes opened up. Drop that block right in. Drop our bolts right in. Okay, see this, the PVA's come up with the tape here, which is good. And I think what I'll do is I'll pull the PVA right off by hand rather than, I don't want to put any water on this. You know, you understand why. I'm telling you, right? The PVA just peels right up like, we'll get it off that way. Just pull it back carefully. And watch your finger, boy. When you get one of those little splinters under your fingernail, is it a joy?
Oh, yeah.
Under the thumb is my favorite.
Under my thumb.
I've had enough things under my thumb. But I wonder if that's how they did that, the Rolling Stones song.
This has gone brand new.
Brand new blades. You can tell the man lived a life of poverty up until today.
Okay. Brand spanking new blade. Look at this. Look at this. A bevy of number 26 blades. Look at this.
Okay, we're ready to trim. We got the block on there. Right. It's in place. We're ready to give the PVA.
And I'll spot you guys 50 crashes.
Don't spot me nothing.
That won't be enough.
Now you could, if you really wanted to, put some tape around the edge of this and then bring it in. But because of our highly skilled knifing staff, able to cut their finger every time they do this.
Frankenfinger.
Love me tender.
Anyway, we're going to bring that down. Get that just a little bit dressed off, block sanded in there as the next step. I'm just roughing this in. And then the last thing is we'll do the edges. And there's always some good little tips you can use even on a geo wing, a foam wing, any kind of wing. That's starting to come right in. And we want to get much of this PVA off. Now to get the PVA off, if you have you can get it off with water, but I don't want to put water near this wing yet.
On the right hand side of the green rack.
It just comes right off.
And it was here's a.
Next step is to outline all the edges with 64th plywood. We just stick them in there. We'll take the hatch out then and get this nice and flat. How are you doing on that wing panel? Smoking along on a leading edge, baby, huh?
Let that
roll into all the.
Take care.
You don't want that to pull a clamshell, a Lyle Larson clamshell. If my leading edge splits in a wing over.
Ellie.
Now that we have the box in there, the next thing is to level it all off. Just rough it out with the Dremel tool. take a last little bit with a sanding block. Always like to drop, get the edges relatively flat before I put the block in, and then do the whole block area all in one step. This one out here, Porky. You got the gear in the other one?
Gear is in.
Okay.
It's gonna be dry in half an hour.
The only thing I don't have, I don't have the aluminum tubes.
Is that all you've got?
The aluminum
tubes. Just one?
Just one. But it's a good one. Hey, when I'm working for Rich, you know, this is about how he fits my motors. 80 grit paper, 40 grit paper.
That's the only one you've got done?
That's it. Pay me.
Yeah, you got a shape.
I'll get started here, basically repeat the same process on this side. As long as I'm getting paid by the hour, paid by the minute.
I can probably lay up another motor crutch while I'm waiting.
That's a good idea, yeah.
Get the PAM out.
Why don't you lay up the fuselage?
We could lay up the fuselage. Actually,
and we're just gonna repeat the same process on the other side. We got one side done.
Richard,
one down, five to go.
Take
that wing and set it. What's the plan? You're going to lay up a fuselage?
I think we will. I think Mr. Oliver and I will lay up a fuselage. First thing.
You haven't been demoted, have you? I thought I was the only one got demoted into from management into labor. Look at this, holy moly. Pizza pies, boats, ringmasters, tons of sandpaper. Oh, it's tough being in labor, baby. I gotta get over there and finish the gear block. Not even, they got me on the clock. It's horrible.
And the feeder will take care of it now, which they're gonna have to do it for.
Really?
And
what else?
I sat with them and they all said.
What is this, 4 ounce, Dave?
I don't even remember, but it's what we use.
Is that
now,
four?
Probably.
Yeah, it feels a little heavier than four.
Now, what'd you put in? One layer of half ounce?
Layer of half, layer of carbon, and a second layer.
Double layer up on a nose section.
This is what we did before.
Okay. Now, do you bag these one at a time, or?
We can bag them one at a time. I gotta make the bags and all that kind of stuff.
Oh, okay,
but
so.
But we can lay these in and.
Okay, but that, and you still got the glue drying on the last wing. Yep. And we're still working on the gear blocks on the number one one.
Pretty much used the 1 inch or an inch and a half brush.
Did you? Oh, we got those.
What's nice is those Home Depot brushes, those like the basting brushes.
You cut them at an angle to where you have a soft tip and you have a firm edge.
Oh, so we got a bunch of those. Yeah. I got a bunch of those right down
somewhere. Works really well.
So you like one of these?
Yeah, only what you do is you cut it at an angle. So when you're spreading, you use the soft part, and then you use this when you're trying to push it in.
Gotcha. I got a bunch of those.
Yeah, we got some. We made those for the.
Are you doing this one with ProSet?
Yep.
That's what I like about doing a fuselage mold. You don't have to be too
you
cute
don't have
about
to
it.
Worry about it, because
it all comes through on a bleeder cloth.
Well, this is also where I use paper towels when we weren't vacuum bagging. Just lay a paper towel in there and let it absorb it.
One little piece like that laid in that corner.
Yeah, we're gonna.
Maybe.
I love the smell of that ProSet.
Yeah.
Mm.
in the morning.
Formaldehyde.
It smells like victory.
Smells like napalm in the morning. Did you make the bag up for this yet?
I'm gonna use the wing bag.
Oh, just use it over?
Sure, why not?
I remember when we were down in the beginning and we were making a bag per part,
and then
we made 10 bags for a couple of the parts where the molds had sharp edges.
Sharp edges.
What a nightmare. Oh. What a nightmare. Unbelievable. Yep.
This Oliver guy knows what he's doing.
He's a good man. Don't lose him. He's so handy.
Big sucker.
Big sucker. Big sucker going by outside. Talk about a vacuum pump.
That's right.
You want to put some atmospheric pressure on the big sucker's out. What do they do, suck leaves up with that thing?
No, it cleans it out for the sewage.
Oh.
Catch basins, I'm sorry.
Tell them we need a little extra help with our vacuum bagging today.
All over the place.
That's very loose weave cloth. It bends nice, but there's a lot of epoxy in between there, boy.
If it doesn't work, well, not use it.
Is this the first time you're using this material?
I think this is what mine is made out of.
Well, but you see there's so much air. There's at least as much air as there is carbon in this. It's not a tight weave. You know what this is? This is 4-ounce stuff that they sell you as 2-ounce because they loose weave it. Or 2.5 or whatever it is. But it bends nice. That's the nice part about this. It bends beautifully.
Yeah, and if you put a layer of real thin glass on the outside, hopefully.
Yeah, you want to know something? I'd put a layer of glass on the inside just to absorb some of that resin.
We did last.
No, inside.
We did last.
Oh, you did? Okay. Even if you put it in like postage stamp, just to absorb some of that resin. And what would happen, Dave, I think, see if the cloth would go down into those little rivet holes where it's solid epoxy.
I think it would. Here you go, Richard. Now, do you want to cut that?
No.
No?
I'll push it in there.
Got it in the bag, so to speak.
Right now we can slide the bag. We can take the whole mold and move it.
Where do you want to run the pump off? At this edge of the table?
If we lift this whole thing up and just move it to that end.
Okay, let me move all this stuff.
Ready?
Right.
Bring this in.
Maybe you'd work on it conveniently there when you got a get the bag to flap down in there. But you must be getting a free electric bill with that fan generating electricity back to the power grid.
Yeah.
I'll bet they owe you money at the end of the month. Look at that fan go, man.
You want to bet they don't.
Why do I have a feeling?
If they do, I don't see it.
It doesn't offset running the vacuum pump for 40 hours a week. Suck it down, Midgley.
Get a grip.
Well, the only way we're gonna know is see how it sucks down. What Rich is doing, that's the most important thing. Keep that the middle has some room to suck down instead of bridging.
Suck down and then
until it so it doesn't bridge. You can hear it. Here it goes. It's going down nice. Going in all the corners here and everything. Sometimes you can pack it right in the corner before it really goes down.
Yeah, this is not going to pack down.
Pull the pressure up.
Wow, there goes the boat.
Oh, that's Tim's new boat.
Oh, yeah?
All right, there's a hole.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I thought I heard there.
Got a duct tape?
I don't know where the hole is yet. Here.
Maybe here. Here's where I was pressing. That's where I was pressing into the corners when you were repumping it.
You need a piece of tape?
No, I don't think tape's done.
Shut the radio off, Woody.
Hold on.
Find it.
I heard it pretty loud there for a second.
Make a new bed.
It's up here.
Most of the time we had it was always around the fitting.
Made a leak.
Yeah, manhandling the fitting probably. It was almost always up by the fittings.
I'll just make a new bed. It's been a long time.
Gonna lay up another crutch? Okay. All right, so you got the heat lamp on the glue here drying. What's the estimated time that's going to be dry?
That's getting
down a home stretch, and then we can snap one together.
What's that?
I'll leave my coat.
All right, Wendy, if you can.
So the first carbon fiber crutch is out of the mold and dressed off, and Dave's going to start laying up another one, and I got two more sets of gear blocks to do, so. We'll roll out the rest of the day. Hope we get those chores done. And well, we got one on, but now we're ready to do Richard's. And Rich has a different control system in his. He's going to go with the custom bulk belt crank that's offset, what, an eighth of an inch, you said?
A little over.
Okay, no forward up line, normal like we're making an Obler. He's got to fit up the tips. This actually, when you put the tip on, you can leave like an eighth of an inch on it, but you got to have a little, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got to have a little lip or something to work off. And he's got a custom belt crank with balling system on one end, two wheel collars holding it in position, and the lead out's bolted to the top. Now putting the tips on, this is just to give you a little lip on the edge so you can glue the tip blocks on. Fuselage is sucking down, it's been on pressure all afternoon. And joining us is world famous Dave Iskins. We're ready to start making up the tip pieces, and Woody's on pattern making. Look at those eagle eyes. And you should have seen how good he was before he became a drunk.
Right.
Iskins, what are you doing? Making a cowl mount?
Yeah, picking a cowl out of five basswood.
Cowl mount?
Yeah.
Oliver's finalizing up the patterns, and I think Midgley's already. What's Midgley doing? Cooking lobsters?
Yeah.
Picked up another $1,000 worth of carbon fiber toe. Look at that, baby, go. Go, baby, go. Hard not to like that.
I had to buy some carbon
veil. Look at this. Look at the cook in action.
Look at that, it's November. We've got the pumpkin.
Look at
tablecloth.
You know, I'm so surprised. How did Mickey Mouse get into this? I thought this is like Thanksgiving.
It's
got the pumpkins going, the Mickey Mouse going. It's an eclectic holiday here at the Build-A-Thon.
Right.
Gonna be an eclectic.
It's like all the holidays wrapped up in one, having you guys here. How's that?
Eclectic.
Hold on.
How are those lobsters doing?
Hey, your uncle's on the phone.
The lobsters swimming around?
They're right here. Check them out.
Elliot on the phone?
No.
Here, that's Les.
Look at those lobsters. Hello. You should be here. They're having lobsters without you.
Yeah, you ever seen it?
No. Put them to sleep. Look at this. Look at this. This is why we're not getting our wings finished. Look at this. He's putting them to sleep. Da 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 da. Hey, it takes simple things to keep a simple mind going.
That's
right. Da
da da da da da da da da da da. He's fighting it.
Well, if they were putting you in a pot of water, you might fight it.
Want to see him put me to sleep?
Yuck, yuck, yuck. He's fighting it.
He knows what you're gonna do to him. He's no fool.
What am I gonna do?
You're gonna eat him. See, Sharon, I'm a good guy. I eat pizza. I don't eat live animals.
Here he goes.
Wait, you have pepperoni in that
I'm
pizza?
I'm a good guy. No.
No.
I'm an aggregate, a vegetarian.
I thought you said
an agitarian.
Pepperoni pizza, Wendy.
Come on.
Of course,
put him to sleep. Look at this.
He's not going.
This live demo by Dave Midgley. Doesn't look like he wants to die.
Look, these ones are all sleeping. I did it.
Yeah. It looks like he'd like to stay alive.
Come on, go to sleep.
Unbelievable. Sharon, it takes very simple things to make this man happy.
Thank God.
One lobster. One mobster.
What? No, Taylor, it's been 7 minutes.
Really?
Yeah. It's quarter after six.
He's going slow.
Right?
What's the purpose of doing this?
It's
you hypnotizing him?
It's just fun to do.
Not fun for the lobster. He looks strong.
I used to be able to put a whole line of them.
Want me to do it?
Man, usually I can get them all to sleep. This guy is just not sleeping.
I think he won this one. He won this round.
No, he loses.
Yeah, well, they don't like that anymore.
We can always erase the tape if something bad's going on up there.
Hey, girls. There's someone here.
It's a panty raid. What's going on? It's candid camera. Are you guys all on a basketball team?
No.
What are you, brownies or what? Holy mackerel. Oh my God. You coming down to have lobsters?
No.
Me either. I don't eat lobsters.
Hi.
Master Chef. Clamshell Larson. Look at this guy go.
Never even had one of these, you know?
Oh.
Never. You eat them, Wendy?
I don't even go near them.
I know.
I'm a meat and pizza man. Look at Woody. Oh my God. Yeah, Woody, don't be bashful. We're closing in on having another set of gear blocks done. And they're ready to do Rich Oliver's major joint. It's El Moo's glue. Now you gonna do both sides of that, Dave?
Yep.
Okay. You have a little flux brush? You could take a little flux brush and just spread that around, or your bare hand even. If you want, I'll do that.
That would be helpful.
Take a little cutoff wheel.
Okay, now you got, yeah, just put some teeth in. You got, that's got a little Cabasil in it. Okay, so that's gonna take a while to dry, but the Elmers will go in an hour. The weld wood or the Elmers, whatever you're going to call it. That'll pot them in nice.
You need more of that?
I don't think so.
I hope not. It's...
Now what about the hole for the pusher rod? You're going to do that? After you get this home?
Yeah.
Okay.
All I gotta do is reach up there and screw into that.
Okay. Yep. I'd put a big glob right on that. You know?
Yeah.
Just let it, yeah, because that's where all the stress is gonna be. Right out there.
On the other side too, I don't think he did it.
He hasn't done this one yet.
Well, what Dave's doing is good too. Just get it all up on top so it can pot.
Yeah.
The more it can pot, the better. We got plenty of acetone to clean your hands. Yeah, that's good what Dave's doing. See, but right up here is where it's going to take all the abuse, right up in that. When Rich makes one of his less than perfect Al Raby type landings.
Nah, not Rich.
Not us.
That's a sign in Alaska when the men are up in the trees working.
Yeah.
It's a cute show. It's up in Alaska. This New York City girl ends up there. It's kind of funny the way she approaches her New York style of life in Alaska. The whitest boy in town finds out his father.
Cabo Sill job.
Get in my belly.
One second, Woody. Wait till he gets over here.
No, I'm dead.
What, honey?
Coming next week?
I don't know.
Are you all set to drop it down?
I think we are.
I don't see why not.
Put glue on both shells?
No, only on one side.
Why the hell isn't that?
You're gonna sand. As you sand the leading edge, just run thin CA down there. It'll wick right in. Okay, you got the bell crank bolt through?
Yep.
You're lined up good there. I think you should put some gallon cans of acetone on there. Did I ever tell you about Rich? I finished his foam wing, sanded the sheeting. You know how you always put it back in the core overnight? With a can of acetone. I get up in the morning, it was a leaking can of acetone. I had foam oatmeal.
There would be no foam there.
Foam oatmeal. I never fell for that trick again. Oh, Dave's got it made. Look at this. Oh my God. Look at this technology. Snappy technology. And the only thing, when you start to carve the tips, when you cut that plate out, it gets... You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we gotta cut it.
Cut away, baby. Cut away.
Probably aren't in this.
We're gonna split it right there. Cutter Dave.
It moved.
Yeah, there's a lot of jobs, Woody, where the old technology still works pretty good.
Duct tape.
Duct tape. A shovel. We gotta dig a hole. Do you want a guy that's computer literate or a guy with a shovel? A guy with 40 years of digging ditches. While they're finishing that, I'll put final touches on the gear block fits here. Still need a little dressing on this one. And what I always do, I always mark them. Which is the inner, which is the outer.
I'd like to
Okay, number two wing going together now. We're going to try something a little bit different on this one. In terms of the glue, we've been using epoxy around the edges. And we're going to try doing these, well, the other one we did with alphatic too. Alphatic the edges and epoxy and cabasil on these so that they pot in. And it is a pleasant sight, the last of the gear blocks getting sanded down right now. And it's well past midnight, so... Oh, you didn't call Edie yet. Uh-oh.
At least she's not midnight there.
Uh-oh. And Dave's got this little glue gun that mixes the glue, but Rich has been mixing it and putting the cabasil in separately. And that's only going on the gear block, so... And Dave's got the epoxy with the cabasil. Pots it in real nice. It's a Rich Oliver trick. He's been giving us some heads up on some of these epoxy things.
I think that's pretty nice.
I think it's great. Got the fuselage, should be ready in the morning. Fuselage half. We ready?
Yep.
Okay, let Rich finish a couple pictures and slap a dually. Line up the bell crank bolt.
I got it.
You got it now? And one of the things we're going to do this time is pin it rather than put it in a plastic bag. We were not happy with having it in that plastic bag last time. It wasn't really working the way we want. Now you may not need as many pins as you think you do. Dave, you may get away with just pinning like one in between each hinge pocket. Go down a leading edge, it won't matter. You're gonna... What do you think? It's got a good fit now? Let me get out of your way. You got a good fit on it. Oh, that's nice.
I think so,
it's
nice.
Huh?
It looks good.
That looks good. Maybe you don't even want to pin it.
No, it's gonna pop up.
I put some weight on it.
I'll pin it.
You got it. Sight down both edges. I think I like this way better than the other way. You have no spread on them at all that I see. You see any that are, like when you press down, they're oozing glue out?
Yeah.
Okay, would you put a couple more pins in there then? I'll have no trouble getting rid of those pinholes in the morning. They'll be gone in one drop of CA and swipe. And actually, you know the pinholes are an advantage? They'll let a little drop of CA wick down into the wood, act like rivets. You know, Rich?
Yeah.
It might actually be an advantage having them.
Like putting toothpicks in
them. Right, like little toothpicks, right. All right, when you guys finish this, I'm going to finish up that one gear block over there. I can't wait to see what time it is. Oh my God, it's after
12:30.
12:30. We're going to turn into unicorns. And we got those seven young kids upstairs banging around and tap dancing and everything. All right, see you in the morning. So this morning, two of them are done. The third one is getting ready, and then we're going to go to breakfast. We work before breakfast, after breakfast, during breakfast.
And some of us get up at 9:30, 10 o'clock.
The closer gets to sleep an extra hour for being the closer. And by the way, who opened the window in the bedroom all the way yesterday?
Was that? I know.
I can't believe you did that to us. That wasn't funny.
It wasn't moi. Wasn't me.
Were those kids upstairs?
Could have been Sharon. Opening the door, opening everything to make it nice. And what the hell is George's last name?
Venturini.
Venturini.
Oh. Well, this is the last step before breakfast. Pin that sucker down. Boy, does that lay in there nice. Luckily, El Mundro caught the fact we hadn't put any tops on the gearbox. Oh, man. Woody, remind him of this. Remind him of this at my funeral next week. That looks good, huh? Yeah, it's nice.
I don't know, whatever it is.
All this, I know is mine's good.
This one looks loose. You got a couple more pins?
No.
Put a weight here. Give me that gallon can of acetone. I don't know. We got three of them in the bank. It just couldn't be better.
Mine's good. Richard's is
mine's good.
Time for breakfast.
Let's go eat it.
Right, two out of three ain't bad, right?
3 ounce airplane, it would fly really, really well.
This looks like an ordinary car. This is Woody's work car, but it's a used up police cruiser. So what happens?
You can't get yourself
out of the back door. There's no door handles on the back, and it keeps you locked until Woody lets you. The sheriff is in town. The sheriff.
Undercover sheriff.
Woody, buy a real car.
Yeah, they give it to me to drive. They pay me to drive.
And it isn't worth it. Buy one from a dealer.
No.
Where they have door locks. Hey, look, there's a Cub coming in. Check this out. Piper Cub. How cool is this? We're starting our next to the last day.
That's a real
one. Oh, that's a nice one. Banjak loves these things.
Oh, I know that.
Listen to that motor. That's a beauty. Oh man, they are nice. I wonder if they're going to be doing banner towing today. Is that Noodles in there, or is that our boys? The criminals we have to hang around with. Anyway, all three wings are now joined.
It's got some warmth in it.
Yeah. Hey, all three wings are in the bank. From this point on, it's all cruise mode.
Here, we'll be at the back. It'll keep you warm like a reptile.
We're making a movie, Waitresses Gone Wild. Are you wild?
I still have some.
Look at this menu. What's wrong with this picture? Tell me what's wrong with that picture, Dave. The pilot's flying backwards.
That's
unbelievable. Maybe Woody. This is very cool. Got a powered glider here. It's looking like it's a beautiful day. I'm glad we got all those wings in a bag, but we still got a lot of work to do. Stayed up so late last night doing those gear blocks. Forgot to put the ones in my wing. You almost put the wing together without the gear blocks. Look how big that wing is. It almost hit the pylon. This scoop up on a nose looks pretty cool. Check that out. Great place to have breakfast, and a lot of people, well, some people eat right out on a patio right by the tails of the planes. The military Cub. I'm not sure we would have won World War II with having these guys bomb Berlin, but.
They were spotters.
Yeah, that's got the glass. Oh, let's see. They are cool. It's a heck of a way to have breakfast. Rich Oliver, Woody, and Cubs.
This goes here.
Would be me.
Senator Bacon.
Thank you.
The criminal element here in Hampton, eating outside while airplanes go by.
Got my mother's car.
We're going to go to this little car collector place on the way home.
Had no problem.
The way back to the shop. Oh, there's a T-Bird in there.
Maybe drop the bomb in
there. Every time we come here, they've got some new cars. It's a very, very unique place. Yesterday there were a bunch of vets out in front of the place, old vets.
There's that sticker in the middle of this window, three.
What's that?
During World War II, that was the amount that gave you a certain amount of gasoline that you could buy.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Quite a bit of stuff in here. A Hemi Cuda here, whatever the hell this thing is. Convertibles. Look at a Hudson convertible. Quite a unique place, quite a unique place. Little Triumph. Great if you got to carry a big plane around. Nice Lincoln Continental. Right out of my childhood, a Thunderbolt Ford. Warren Walker's car. This is Warren Walker's car. Warren, eat your heart out. Look at this thing. Got the big scoop on the hood.
Got one.
Fairlane, that's nice. Very cool. The old Vet, 63 Vet in there, that's nice. Z28.
What's that say, 75,000 for that Camaro?
I can't read it. This is a Sunliner. This is one of those ones that has the convertible hardtop.
Yeah. Yeah. Is Dingman's open to the public?
Anyway, we're going to take a little walk here. John Pothier's favorite car. Oh, it's a 66. Shows you what I know. A Corvair. We always enjoy a little stop here. They always have some new stuff. Oh, he's got all the trophies in the back. Looks like he won the Walker Cup here a few times. A convertible, too. Z28, 4-speed. Like a poor man's Barrett Jackson here. Got the original dials on it. Nice paintwork. Stick 4-speed. Some very, very cool stuff. I thought this was one of those hardtop convertibles. It's not. Jaguar. '62 Vet. Not sure what year John's Vet is. Something just went by. Overhead. This would be my personal favorite. What?
You gotta come out here and take some video of this.
What's going on?
T6.
The T6 just came back.
I heard it. Where is he? Oh, I see. He's out there. I heard the engine. I didn't know.
He even put the prop tips on it.
There he is. Is he going to go into Hampton?
I doubt he'll go into Hampton. He might.
Well, he's coming in low.
He might.
He's coming around now. I heard that noise. Always something going on in Hampton Beach. Yeah, we can hear him now. What a sound, what a sound. That is cool. That is, it's hanging in his shop. This is Warren's car here, exact car. Look at this.
It's sparking.
Believe it or not, this is one of my favorite cars. You can put some stunt chips back here, Dave.
This is what Campbell would love. Campbell would absolutely love this thing.
Yeah.
A Carmen Ghia.
Yep.
The old Cabriolet.
Yep. 57 there.
This is just... Who is that?
Another 57 in the back. There's some nice scoops for you. Is that your boat there, Dave?
Yeah.
Not exactly.
You had another table.
You got enough carbon fiber there, Oliver? What are you gonna do, make it?
I'm gonna hurt somebody.
And charge Bill Rutherford double if he wants any carbon fiber.
Nice in here.
Oh, look at this. Look at this collector.
Hey, get through the door.
Hey, get that thing out of here before somebody knocks it over. That plane. How'd it dry up? Good?
You know what we can sand on?
What?
Turn this over.
Flip it over. That's a good idea. You're done there. That's dry. Just take that out. We'll put it in the sun for an hour, and I'll work on the other one. So they're all three joined. Two. Third one. You're sending that back home with me in a car?
I'd like to.
Well, I don't want to reload the car till we actually leave tomorrow, so...
I know.
Lay it over in a corner. I think it'd be safe.
Now, are you staying tonight?
Okay, what we're doing, the next step on this is we just roughed this out with the heavy block to the point where we're happy with it. And now what's happening is you have a hard area, and in fact, this still has PVA on it. It's hard, soft, hard. So we need to harden up the spot where we've gone through and seal the edge where the glass fibers come up on the end. And that's probably as easy as it gets to do. And you can see the joint is almost an invisible line. It's thinner than a pen line would be. Oh, that smells so good. Run your hand on that now, feel how that is. Just get a, that's coming nice.
Yeah.
Happy with that?
Yeah.
Okay, now if you hold it in that position. Can you hold that and I can hold that? Now eventually we're gonna pick up the high spots and we'll give that another coat. And if I was you, I'd take, before, obviously, when we get down with the leading edge, we'll just sand the PVA off with 320. It'll come right off. Okay, now we've got one little spot here that's an issue. As soon as you build up a layer of the CA on there, then it sands this relatively hard, and the fiberglass, and it blends right in. The aliphatic definitely was the best way to do this. I'm glad each time we do this, we seem to learn some little tips, like putting the gear blocks in. They forgot to put my gear blocks in. These guys are sabotaging it. Just let it kick.
Let's not mention it was his job.
It was my job. Don't mention that on the video. They left me in charge and I fell asleep at the switch is what happened. Hey, DJ, how you doing?
Good. You just sat on breakfast, huh?
What happened? You sat on breakfast? You went to the car place, too.
I didn't know where you guys were going. No one told me.
It's called sleeping at the switch. Only the closer gets to sleep late.
I wasn't sleeping.
We thought you were boycotting us. You wanted to be with all those young girls upstairs. Yeah, are they right. Still upstairs?
Oh, they all left. No one told me you guys were heading out. So where's the old man and the other old man?
Basement, I think they went to the basement and start cleaning up. They said we were sloppy workers. You know, they complained about cleaning up after Leonardo, too. They said it was a lot of dust on the floor. Leonardo Oliver.
Rembrandt Jet.
Rembrandt Jet. We're going to get to a point here very soon. In fact, I think we're very close to it already. Just to get rid of these high spots. One more high spot here. I want to see, before I go with the shoe shine, I want to make sure I have this, because this will be the first thing to wear out. I want to make sure I haven't cheated that. One more coat, I think we'll have it. And when you tissue it, are you going to tissue it? Just wring the front one over, you know, so it's double on the front. And that saves a lot if you get little stone mix and stuff. Oh, I love that smell. Okay, let me get a piece of sandpaper. And we're about ready to start cleaning up here. We're going to work on finalizing that leading edge shape for Rich. We're really very concerned about getting Rich's wing ready because it's got to be shipped to Texas. I'm going to take mine home with me, and Dave, of course, will keep his up here. But while we're all together here for the last day, we take a nice coffee break, and we want to get the final shape on this. And there is, if in doubt, a little flatter radius is better than a little too pointy. Every time. These wings really came out nice. We've really been pulling a midnight shift on these. We were up till after 1:30 last night, but boy, you can see the coffee cups from last night. It paid, because now we're in the driver's seat. And this is always the shoe shine. What is this, 320? This should get out any extra high spot, but you don't want to do this until you have the leading edge the same hardness as the wing or similar. I'm going to get your hand here. The trick is kind of just to hold it loose in your hand, not put too much pressure on it, let the sandpaper do the cutting. Okay, one more coat, I think, and we'll have it. You'll really have it too. Nice. you don't have to worry. What happens with these, this is where you've got a little bit of cloth just going through. When we sand off the PVA, those will go away. Rub your hand on that, see what that feels good to you. Any little spot you... See, here's where the cloth just ends, but it doesn't matter, because when you sand on this, you can just bring this around. Give it one more shoe shine, and we'll move on to the other side. And once you tissue that, if you double tissue it, boy, oh boy, then you can really work that edge. But that line is so thin, that center line, which is always handy too. If you need to line up the wing, you can just sand a little spot and pick up the center line instantly. And you can always pick it up out here. I think you're in, Ravy. That's it. That's ready for finish. That looks good to you? Okay, so now we're just going to basically repeat same thing on the other side. And then that step will be done. Now you can always tell a pecking order in Dave's shop. Who's in management, who's in labor, and who's in janitorial services? And who sits around drinking vodka all afternoon?
Chief cook and bottle washer.
I'm impressed. All right, Rich and I are sanding this out. As soon as he gets done with his shop vac, we'll get back. 220 is usually the paper of choice for a good sand out. You really want to get that scuffed up before we put the dope and the tissue and everything on it. But we really like working in a pleasant, clean environment. Okay, back to work after a soda break. How's that coming there, baby?
Nice and slick.
This is the tip off. Oh, I love it. Oh, that is one really nice straight wing, baby. Now here's one of the old prototypes that we made with totally different technology, but one of the original ones, I don't know what year that was made, one of the original ones from, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 years ago. And the state of the art. And the future of the hobby, right here.
Just starting.
As soon as he's done sanding that out, he's going to start flaps. And then we'll bring this one over to the padded table and do the leading edge. I'll do the leading edge for you. How much, did you get some of the glue off of this already? Or just,
nope.
It just. No problem at all. You don't even need sandpaper. You can just peel it off. Boy, that's nice. That's a nice accessory. You know why it doesn't stick to the fiberglass good? That is nice. Hold on 1 second, Dave. Hold that end of the wing. Oh. All right. There we go. And you're almost done with this. Then you're going to start the flaps?
I'll start flaps.
Okay. And then when you're done, we'll bring that one over to this table. And we'll get the leading edge. This leading edge radius is just about as sweet as can be on there. Just a pen line going down on the joint.
Here, what Dave is doing, we sprayed, this is the bottom of the mold. And we're putting the what is 120? 120 sandpaper down with contact cement. Get it straight, you don't get to do it. No, the other way around.
This curve up here, because we're going to use this edge.
All right.
I think you're going to need one more. I've got one more. All I care about is the seam is decent.
What's good is when you're done with a sanding belt, save it.
Oh, yeah.
One of those rough belts.
Here's another one.
Okay. This will get our trailing edges nice.
Here. Okay.
Okay, this piece you're going to have to cut because you got that edge there.
Fine.
So you can put it the other way. Maybe just put it the other way, let it try to lop it off. And when you want to take the sandpaper off, just use a heat gun, hair dryer, take it right off. What I do, I use up all the contact cement that we had from the years when it used to melt the foam wings.
Yep.
Everybody seems to have 5 cans of that stuff somewhere in their shop, including us. All right, so we got rough sandpaper here, smooth and rough. Okay, lay it down. Just keeps the edge from floating up. Now the only thing can bite us if you eat up a joint. I think that'll be fine. But a sanding belt is still better than this.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that'd be good. With the bigger sandpaper, you can move it around a little bit, too. Already making flaps. He's ahead of us. He's got the lead.
Oh, he's the train whistle.
I hear the train a coming. It's coming to Hampton, New Hampshire. Let's see what we got.
More money.
More money. All right, wait, some of his PVA there. Okay, Rich is getting ready to start cutting up flaps. He's making 3/8 flaps. Mine will be 1/4 inch.
Whatever you want to do,
I don't know what Dave's going to have. 1/4 or 3/8 doesn't seem critical on this wing. This one's ready to pull a PVA off. The leading edge is done. Woody's going to take the motor out of the plane. What do you need, a 440? That one's going back to Jersey. As soon as you get the stuff out of it, I'll put it in the car.
You gotta take whatever wrench it is to fit to his muffler.
How's that feeling? Good?
It feels so nice.
Got it out?
Oh, yeah.
Al Raby way. Okay. So you basically put a piece of tape down here and then just carve to the end?
Yes.
And leave the front?
Leave the front flat.
Okay.
That way you don't need the rods.
Yeah.
Sand down to the line, between the lines, this line, that line.
Okay.
Not quite to the line. I like to leave about 1/8 of an inch, really.
Yeah, yeah.
What's this?
I like to put, when I do mine, 1/8 inch tape on the trailing edge.
Yeah.
And obviously there's a million ways to rods. Elliot made some nice ones with the rods last year.
Yeah, the rods work, and they work if you're going from one end to the other, but
right.
They won't work if you're just taking half of it.
Right, right.
So in the past I've had trouble with it warping, so I feel like leaving this full meat tends to keep
it. It can't hurt. Yeah, more material is going to be. This looks like nice wood.
Yeah, that's good. That should be fine. Nice and straight. You got a center line on that already? Oh, yeah.
So you leave them full width and then just taper them from halfway back.
The first inch or so, I'm guessing, or the middle. What'd you do, work off the middle?
I worked off the middle here, but out at the tip, if it looks really fat, too far.
Yeah, just taper it, like a wing tip.
Taper it a little bit.
Yeah, more. Yeah.
But it's still, this is the best way for me to shake it and leave as much meat on here to keep it from twisting.
The one thing good, if Elliot was here, he's really a pro at making flaps. How many flaps did he make last year? Like 10 flaps or something? I still got two spares.
20 or 30 sets.
He made flaps. He was like in production mode.
He was flap man.
The fact we were beating him with a stick, I don't know if that had anything to do with it. We had him handcuffed to a table.
Well, the first 26 sets didn't come out, so we had to...
He used up all of Midgley's good wood, I think.
No, we were trying all kinds of things. We tried some out of foam, we tried some out of Roacell.
Yeah, that's right. We tried him
in the mold, he tried them.
Right. He was still convinced he could make them in that mold.
He was in experimenting mode, and that was fine.
All right, so what do we got to do? We got to sand the top of this wing.
And
you're ready to start carving?
Sanding, yep.
Sand and carbon, okay. Which table do you need so I can plan out my management role here?
I can float.
You can float?
He can float.
Work over here.
Using the Al Raby method, the flaps are coming right together. Did you put a new blade in that?
Yeah.
Man, I find out.
What's this? You want to tape with the last
a new half? Blade really makes that go quick. Next thing is there are a bunch of little divots because what we did, we ended the glass, we sanded this back down to the wood so we'd get a square edge. We got to fill these little pieces. Dave's mixing up some Bondo. One little scoop of do of Bondo. Mix that good. That's,
trust me.
That's key. You've used Bondo before. Okay, we would have used Aeropoxy Light except that it would take longer to dry and we want to get going on this. Only a couple of more steps, and we're gonna go be ready to rock here, baby. Next year's wings won't have this problem.
No, they won't.
There'll be no problems with the trailing edge.
This isn't that bad.
Real problem. Not once you when you're done, there's gonna be nothing. That there's only gonna be little divots in there, so. You don't even have to worry about it.
When I'm done, you won't see a thing.
The harder you make those edges and corners, you may have to pack epoxy with a little Cavastel into the corner before you lay the glass in.
That's a good idea.
Because that glass really...
I wonder if you could do that.
That's what we should have done.
That's a great idea.
You pack that hard corner and then lay the glass in, and you get a nice crisp... resin only.
And the cloth keeps it from coming out. When the vacuum sucks up.
The next wing will have that.
Then we're going to come here and dress it off on the big table. The big table.
We just laid them in and pushed them into the corner. There was nothing to help. So the cap seal really had to make all the hard corners.
I know what's on now. If you hold it up straight.
Yeah, it may have.
But you know, every one that we do at ease, we get little things that make it better. There's like a series. This is the second series of, probably the third series of wings.
Third. Yep. Each one is definitely better.
Just having those hinge pockets in the last set was good.
Oh, yeah.
That was a big upgrade.
I remember cutting it in when you didn't have any slots.
Was that murder?
Even that electric cutter didn't want to cut.
Nah, you're just smoking and burning and everything.
Man.
Well, let's let that cure out before we even go over to the bench. The part we all like, right, Woody?
Yeah.
Keeping the janitors busy.